I've moved back over to the table, so I've got a little room to spread out my cable here. And I'm going to find the center of my cable, which is right here where it's marked 42 feet. The length of the lettering is about an inch wide, and I'm going to take about an inch and a half of the insulation off of it. I'm going to take some masking tape, use this to put it on the black cable to make my mark on. Just kind of wrap that around there nice and neat. Piece on the other side. I'll take the ruler. So right here I can still see the mark. And set that right about there. I'm going to mark one side 3/4 of an inch and mark the other side at 3/4 of an inch, and that should be an inch and a half across there. And I can go ahead and draw this on over. So now I'll take my X-Acto knife and try to carefully cut just the outer jacket. If I screw up this part, then I won't be making a 75 meter antenna. I'll be making a 40 or 30 meter antenna. So very carefully. I've got a new blade in this, so this should be pretty easy. One thing about this cable I'm using, it has a very thick outer jacket. Cable over. I'm going to be careful and don't cut all the way through the braid. Put a slit down the center. Next thing is to cut the braid in the center. And I've got my knife blade up instead of down, so I don't want to accidentally cut the dielectric. Peel that back. Fold that back and kind of twist the wire. And now I've got to take this aluminum foil off of the metal tube. It's just peeling off. And most of it did. Just trim it off. Make sure the wires aren't in the way, aren't going to short out. Straighten up the leads. Okay, on the ends of my cable, I made those 4 inches longer. And so now, let's see, move this out of the way. This is the end that first came out of the box. It's marked at 0 feet. And it had the knot in the end of it. I'm trying to straighten that out. I'm going to strip off most of that. I'm going to mark this at 4 inches. Get that cable straightened out. Okay, take the X-Acto knife. And again, very carefully cut only through the insulation, the outer jacket. If you just score it fairly deep, you can kind of tear the jacket off without going all the way through the jacket. Slit down the center of it. Okay, I'm going to take that little piece of tape off, push this down, scrunch it up like that. Give it a bend up here. Start separating the braid. Once you get this separated and pulled back right down here, if you have a problem, just push it down to loosen it. Until you get to a point where you can get your awl or your nail or whatever you're using all the way through there. That. We'll give this, pull this down and start pulling it out. I'll separate those two. Then I'll trim that foil off. There's two nice long leads there. So there's one end, and now I'm going to do the same thing to the other side and get that ready to go. I'm going to mark that at 4 inches and cut the outer jacket off and separate the leads. Next thing I'm going to do is strip off the dielectric off of both of the ends of this section of the antenna. And let's see, not sure where to start here. Let's try 16 gauge and see how that works. Okay. Come all the way down to the end very carefully. It appears to be 16 gauge wire. There's my wire lead from one side. Take the other end. See if I can do this too without cutting it off. On the two tail sections, I'm going to take and measure. I allowed 2 inches. So I'm just going to measure that. This doesn't strip off as easy as that dielectric. There we go. So, take the other one. Measure down 2 inches. And those two look even. Now I'm ready to solder all of my connections. And I've got my antenna section, my coaxial section of the antenna, firmly secure here. I've got this kind of bolted down so it's nice and snug, so when I pull on it, it doesn't pull out. And now that I've stripped a little bit of insulation off of these wires, bend that up. Let's try that. And about the only thing I do is just kind of wrap the smaller wire around the larger wire. Take some solder. And the soldering iron. Just kind of solder all the way around it. Okay. Now I'm going to short the end of my coaxial cable. If you're using coaxial cable for the tail sections, you're going to do it the same way. You're going to short the two wires together and solder them, and do that on the other section of cable too at both ends, and then you can solder the two sections together and do it that way. So I'm probably going to trim off the braid and use this center section for the antenna lead, for the antenna element. So this should be fairly simple. And I'll do the other side the same way. There it is, soldered together. Go ahead and trim it off. I put some solder all the way around it. Trim off the braid. Now I'm going to solder my tail section onto the main section of the antenna. And on the antenna, let's see, on the coaxial side, I've got 4 inches of extra wire. I don't really need that much. It just made it easy to cut and calculate using that length. And I've got 2 inches of wire here, this 14 gauge stranded wire. And whenever I solder this together, I might want to leave my lead a little bit long so that, again, in the future I can change the tail section if I want to and use coaxial cable instead of this wire. Let's see here. Just kind of twist this around here. One wire, wrap it around the other. Take the other wire, wrap it around the other side. Pull on it a little bit. Okay, this is the lead from the coaxial cable, and this is the lead from the 14 gauge wire, and I've wrapped those around each other, and that's going to leave about a 1 inch gap in between the two. Go ahead and solder these. trim that off and see what it looks like on the other side. Yeah, I could use a little solder on the other side. Trim that off. I'm going to take some vinyl tape and tape that up. When you're finished making all your connections, you want to insulate them all. I've got to go back and insulate the feed point. You could use some coaxial seal or tape, or a combination of coaxial seal and tape. You just put a layer of tape on, then you put your coaxial seal on, then you put another layer of tape on. Probably put more tape on that too later. And then next I'll try to get the other end to match this end. Okay. Go to the other side. Check my distance. Kind of pull it apart a little, about an inch. Wrap that wire around there. Solder it all together. Take a little more solder. And I'll take some tape and tape up this side. Thank you. I only have a couple of more things to do, and that's put the end insulators on and then put some coaxial seal on the feed point. I cut these 18 inches longer on this end, and plus there's about an extra inch up at the other end where it's connected to the coaxial cable. So I'm just going to go ahead and bend that at 19 inches. And let's see, put a clip on here. Put insulator on it. Find my bend. Okay. Just put it right here for the time being. And then I can just take some of that vinyl tape and just tape the wire for now. Put a bend in it, a clip on it. Make sure I got the right side. And again, those are 1/16 inch wire rope clips. Come back and put some tape on that. Before I put it up, I'll probably try to stretch it out and make sure all the ends and the lengths are all equal. I'm going to make both halves of the dipole equal. And last, take the feed point connector and some coaxial seal and seal that up. Well, I can stick it under the bottom right now. I may have to pull this all back off in order to do a really good job of wrapping that up. Down here at the bottom. Just press it on and mold it on.